Hello everyone and welcome to the map Tropical Sacrifice. Joining me in the upper right here wielding the blue probes, it is going to be Astrea. And the Protoss opponent warping in the bottom left with the red Nexus, it is Neeb. Astrea versus Neeb. Guys, it's a PvP, I know. You're like, oh, Protoss. Nobody wants to watch Protoss. Need I remind you, ladies and gentlemen, if you're a Protoss player, you should watch PvP because they're both Protoss. It's your faction, your chosen team. And if you're Terran or Zerg, you should watch PvP, because then you can watch the Protoss take some time to slaughter each other. What is going on in this game, though? Not a whole lot of slaughtering just yet, it seems. Instead, we're going with Nexus block. Multiple Nexus block, of course. Probes angry. Lightning strike. The attack that feels so much more dramatic than it actually is. How does it look to the probe's point of view? Slapping down that pylon, blocking the Nexus. They're both going for the double gas here. Astrea's was a little bit slower, but not by so much that I think it's going to be game-changing, world-ending. Zealots. Not actually Zealots, though. We're just canceling. He's not canceling. Astrea says, no, I want that Zealot. Neeb's the one getting fancy here, making a Zealot, canceling a Zealot. Ooh, solid Zealot. Micro actually gets a hit off on the probe there. Sentry follower. Stalkers. No Nexus just yet. Did I speak too soon? He's got the money. He's gonna do it. 410, 420. There we go. Alright. Good job, Neeb. Killed off that probe too. One kill on the stalker. Oh, I'm sorry. That wasn't dramatic enough. Probes slaughtered, brutalized on the map already. 3 minutes into the game, and we already have blood? Oil? Energy? What are probes made of? Do they have oil? Oil spilled on the map. Somebody alert Chevron. Stalkers, thinking that they are so powerful they can just walk across to the other side of the map. There is only one stalker for Astrea, of course, but that stalker, he's not alone. He's got friends, and the most important friend is, of course, the shield battery. Yes, you guessed it correctly. Hallucinated Phoenix going to get the scout off. Sees the Twilight. Sees that additional gateway. Third stalker here, but second going to pop out for Astrea, who's been operating off of a one gate. Oh, beautifully done, actually. A little rare, it feels, to see one gate. Does he have more coming? He went for the robo. No. No, he does not. Interesting choices in the builds here. So we've got Neeb with the additional gateway going for the Twilight. Astrea skipping the gate and the Twilight, going instead straight for the robo. And so far, he's only used it for observers. No wonder Neeb felt like he could do damage. I mean, he couldn't really because, you know, shield batteries exist, and Astrea, unlike some of the Platinum League, built any amount of units, yes. Hallucinated Phoenix, both scouting and getting scouted. Couple shots by the stalkers. Obs, seeing everything there is to see. There is one coming for Neeb. The observer battle. Oh no. No! No, Astrea. No. So much time and energy from Kali Smith's went into making that observer. How could you just throw it away? Immortal follow-up. For Astrea, nothing. Still for Neeb, though. Still working on those obs, so maybe there's the value in the quicker robo, guys. You get your mandatory observers out, then you can start working on the immortal production, the warp prism. Just a little bit quicker. Blink is done for Mr. Neeb, though, and that gives him quite a hefty advantage in the Stalker versus Stalker battles. Neeb showing the Adepts. Single Stalker going to push out. My money's on the Stalker, actually. Good block by Astrea, forcing the Adept Shades over there. Warp Prism. Oh, accidentally picked up the Sentry. Oh, the Zealot even getting in on the action here. Adept shading forward. Battery up. Recall initiated. One. Not going to make it home, though. Hmm. Sucker for that Terran Brood War music, as you all should be. So good. So good. Obs for Neeb getting the perfect scout off, gonna set up shop over the third base. However, Astrea. Revenge. The revenge kill. Observer destroyed. Picked off. Neeb going for the fourth base. Can he do that? Are you allowed to do that? We should ask the dog. Is he allowed to take this fourth base? Is the immortal enough? Not enough to save it, that's for sure. Stalker gonna be picked off, though. That's a lot of sentries. Batman, that's a lot of sentries. You gonna force field? No blink still, so. You know, force fields actually could be rather damaging. Useful versus the immortals versus the stalkers. He's getting charge before blink. I like it. As someone who knows their limitations and should not get involved with blink micro, I'm a supporter of the charge first. Moving into archons now, both of them, really. The beauties of PvP. You never really know what you're gonna get. You can expect, you can try and predict, and then be joyfully surprised a few minutes later when the random Dark Templar shows up, but no DTs yet. Yet. That's the important part. Hallucinated Phoenix. Scouting into the base, but likely looking for the army. There's two, even. He doesn't know that the army's over here. Astrea got that fourth base up. Neeb's did eventually finish. And now Neeb gonna push into the base here. We have a battle impending. Gets up into the natural, sends quite a few zealots in there, the rest of the army. Do you try and hold them off? Oh, exploit the positioning, try and get a surround on the Archon. Guardian shield's going to be used. Neeb's zealots getting damage done in the base, killing off probes. Archon's trying to desperately hold the front line. The Archon count does go to Astrea, which means the game should as well at this point. What's going on over here? Zealots doing some damage from Astrea. Meanwhile, pushing the army back. Four probes so far have gone down. Warp in defensively, but not gonna save enough of the probes. Full surround, an honorable death. Astrea chasing Neeb all the way back home. Neeb is getting some disruptors, which if they could get here would be very helpful. The question is, will they get here quick enough? Probe loss is actually relatively even through that exchange. Neeb had the upper hand for the first little bit, but Astrea artfully punching back. Gotta get rid of that dial-up pylon. Archon's trying to hold the base. There is a disruptor here, and then, oh, firing on his own probes. Battery overcharge gonna be a second. Disruptor shot is a whiff. Archon juggling going on by the warp prism. Probes still dying off in this exchange though. And the immortal count. Astrea has the immortal count. He could just target fire this building down if he wanted to. Immortals, not such a great answer versus disruptors unless they can just outright kill it off. Neeb is going to deflect this. We all know how strong shield batteries are, and that's an unfortunate army setback for Astrea. He's down to one immortal, one archon, not for long. He does get it. He does pick it up. Warping in a lot of zealots back home. Will it be enough to save him though? Neeb with the army supply advantage, 55 to 40. Most of it is in archons, which, you know, Astrea does have a lot of zealots. If they get a surround, they might be okay. If they cannot get the surround though, guys, archons are good. Archons are very strong. Disruptors still joining the party. Dark Shrine. I told you it would happen eventually. This other one, also afflicted with the dial-up sickness, says we need to get rid of that pylon, guys. Oh no, they went the other way. Did you see where they went? Hey, double Dark Shrine on the way. Magnificent. When behind Dark Shrine, when ahead Dark Shrine, when unsure about what to do Dark Shrine. Zealot, the micro from the disruptor. Oh, he picks it up. Zealot's very quick to target fire that disruptor down. There's a couple zealot, not anymore. There's a couple cannons. There's a couple cannons over there getting stuff done. Zealots thinking about getting in here, but they're not going to be able to get much done there. Who's ahead? DT Blank. Did you know those are faces? And they glow when Blink is being researched. Warp Prism in the main base. It works versus Terran. It works versus Zerg. Why not have it work versus Protoss? Zealots get in here trying to target fire the battery. Not the best of positioning though. This army, there's a Colossus here. It's Protoss, it's PvP. Oh, DTs versus DTs. Oh, they do actually kill each other off. Observers, very important in that battle. A sad day when Narazim fights Narazim. Indeed. Does he see this? Oh yeah, he sees it. Zealot's going to be deflected by an impressive army, honestly. It's a lot of disruptors, some archons, and the Colossus. You tell me what we should name the Colossus. I'm definitely feeling a name that starts with the letter C, because obviously, you know, Colossus. Zealots, unsure about their purpose in life. Meanwhile, the army's just positioning, boxing. Although the supplies are relatively the same, I think I have to give the advantage to Neeb. Oh, recall initiated, bringing the main army home. 16 probes killed off though from Neeb. That's a bit damaging. That is not good, guys. Neeb's army is a bit superior unless these three robos start cranking out the disruptors. Oh, he gets the shot off. Beautifully done. Counter shot. Neeb blinking forward, picking off a couple disruptors. Oh, the DT blink onto the cannon. DT is now going to be able to wreck this place. There is no detection, and now there's no probes. Soon enough, there will be no hope. DT versus DT yet again. They are going to get the Nexus though, and the main army is squaring off over here. Another excellent disruptor hit from Astrea. Neeb, I said he had the better army, and he still, it's debatable. He doesn't have any more disruptors though. Oh, that's not good. He's leaning more into the Archons, which in a straight up engagement, the Archons will do fine, of course, but the disruptors, Archons cannot move out of the disruptor hit. Astrea going to take the game, switching into the disruptors right at the tail end of that match, and it's going to be the perfect move. Neeb leaning into the Archons, they just can't compete versus the disruptors. Beautifully done, and a well-earned victory. If you enjoyed, be sure to let me know in the comments below, guys. Thank you so much for watching, as always. I hope you have a great day.